The story here is a 5-minute charge gets you a longer way than we expected it to, you know, just last week, really looking into thinking there. Let's have a listen.
The second generation Shenxing is fully compatible with the latest megawatts level superfast charging station on the market. We look forward to collaborating with more industry leaders to push the limits of the superfast charging through the true innovation. So let Shenxing superfast charging battery become the standard for the electric vehicles.
Minmin Lo is here with us to help us unpack how big of a game changer this new, this new technology could be.
Yeah, well, obviously, it's going to encourage more mass market adoption of EVs because one of the barriers to buying an EV is the perceived limitation around the range of an EV. So CATL is unveiling this battery that can charge within 5 minutes and offer you 520 kilometers in range, which is further than what BYD announced sometime back. 400 kilometers was what BYD had. And this is not the only innovation that CATL unveiled. They also announced the launch of this sodium ion battery, which is more weather resistant, so it can operate in very cold conditions like negative 40 degrees. It's also because sodium is more stable than lithium, it's more fire resistant, so it's safer and it's also cheaper than a lithium ion battery. So CATL is expecting that this battery could eventually replace about 50% of the market share that is now dominated by lithium phosphate or iron ion batteries. And they also unveiled this dual power battery that can offer you 1,500 kilometers in range. So it combines a regular fast charging battery with an auxiliary pack to enhance the performance. So just the speed of all these innovation really shows you how competitive the domestic market is. And the CATL executive did mention that this rat race, while it's good for innovation, he said it's actually not too healthy, that price competition there. And he hopes that the highest standard that China can set would get rid of some of the poorer quality products out there.
I mean, when it comes to competition, it's not just among the battery makers, among the EV makers as well. And we're hearing that Nikkei is reporting BYD looking to launch something in the Japanese market by early next year. I mean, how would that even work, given how difficult it is, we know, to crack the Japanese auto market?
Yeah, so BYD is planning to launch a mini car in Japan by 2026. Mini cars now make up about 40% of the Japanese market. And like you said, because Japanese roads are narrower, they have very key specifications for cars to operate. They're very tight safety standards as well. So these are some of the non-tariff barriers that the U.S. has complained against. And BYD has independently come up with a car that meets those specifications. And it's going to be a threat to these domestic car makers that have been dominating the market. And these Japanese car makers, they have been already facing declining market shares overseas. Some of them are making losses, having production cuts, job cuts. And on top of that, they now have to face those reciprocal tariffs, the sectoral tariffs from the US. And don't forget, there is the US-Japan talks where the revision of safety standards is on the table. If Japan compromises and agrees to accept US safety standards, that opens the floodgates further for US car makers to push and make further inroads into Japan. So a lot of competition coming for the Japanese car makers. At the same time, it's also, of course, BYD's way to grab market share overseas to increase their profitability. And this comes as BYD also recently signed an agreement with Saudi Aramco to combine forces in research to improve efficiency for new energy vehicles, which is quite an interesting collaboration given that Saudi Aramco is a traditional oil company that has frequently expressed its skepticism over the pace of this transition away from fossil fuels.